Thank you, Eric, and good afternoon, everyone. Governments can deliver a strong deal in Copenhagen, and nothing has changed my confidence in that. We need more movement. Governments have between now and Copenhagen to make their commitments clear. And an agreement in Copenhagen must record, in black and white, the commitments of individual governments on, first, ambitious industrialized country emission reduction targets for 2020, second, developing country plans to limit emissions growth, third, a clear, short and long-term funding arrangement from rich countries, and fourth, an equitable structure to manage and deploy that money. In that context, I look to industrialized countries to raise their ambitions to meet the scale of the challenge that we face. I particularly look to the United States to announce a clear numerical midterm target, and I have been consistently assured by US representatives that this can be done. I also look to all industrialized nations for clarity on the amount of short and long-term finance they will commit to in Copenhagen. At Copenhagen, they must deliver an outcome which presents a strong, functioning architecture to kickstart rapid action in the developing world. Here in Barcelona, further progress was made towards this, which will be captured in working texts as the basis for the work in Copenhagen. On technology, a text that includes a possible technology mechanism has been crafted. On capacity building, there has been good progress. On reducing emissions from deforestation in developing countries, there is increasing agreement that implementation should be in different phases, and countries are also discussing financing options for that. And there has been further convergence towards an architecture on financial governance. Governments must leave Copenhagen with agreement on how to make all parts of the Bali Action Plan immediately operational. In that context, the Kyoto Protocol is the only legally constituted working model we have of international commitment and cooperation to reduce greenhouse gases. And you don't saw off the branch you are sitting on. And there is a strong sense that the Kyoto Protocol needs to continue. We are not really so far away from the ambition that enlightened political leadership can and must deliver. After Copenhagen, talking action must turn into taking action, and it can be done. Thank you.